cost related to choices we make on our infrastructure, certainly as it relates to cyber and protection of that infrastructure, have a direct impact on cost for our organization. Having been in the industry for almost 35 years, I can tell you that this story has never changed. Stay tuned for some detailed information on the differences between an on-site infrastructure, cloud-based infrastructures, and associated costs with those decisions. So let's start with a ground perspective of what, kind of a foundational perspective of what on-site versus as a service means. So when we talk about on-site resources, we're really talking about everything within your data wall, typically behind your firewall. You have network administrators and system administrators. They're locally managing your infrastructure, everything inside of your organization. That's on-site. When we move to infrastructure as a service, really we're talking about the types of services available with infrastructure as a service. So we're going to get into that more in another screen here in just a minute. But infrastructure as a service is, I'm getting rid of some of my services to a cloud provider, but I'm still managing about half of those services internally with internal resources. And then platform as a service is less things that we have to manage, right? We're basically just delivering the application so that it can be used. Typically, you'll find platform as a service with development shops where they can test and easily provision equipment. Not worrying about the infrastructure, just worrying about how the application or that virtual container or whatever it is that they're using is working properly. And then the last is software as a service. Now, software as a service typically is a service that we purchase. A great example of software as a service is Netflix. We have a subscription to Netflix and they serve up movies. Another example may be Amazon. If you're purchasing services from them to do, for example, your shopping, that's a software as a service. Those are loosely defined, but we're going to get into some more definitions here in just a moment. So security cost depends upon the choices that you make, whether you make the choices for on-site, IaaS, PaaS, or SaaS. So what do those choices look like? When we start looking at on-site, we're going to list there 8 primary things that you would support within an on-site infrastructure. For example, applications, data, middleware, operating system, virtualization, server storage, and network. All of those additional that's not listed there is firewall, your boundary, your caching devices, things of that nature. It's not an all-inclusive list, but you get the picture, right? And that's why the score of 10 has been assigned to on-site, 10 being the most costly to run our infrastructure. And remember, it's the infrastructure, all of those 8 items there, that provide services to the customers. So when you log on to your computer to do your email, somebody else is handling all of those 8 services and additional services in the background. The next area that we talk about really is infrastructure as a service. Notice that the number is 6. The number is a 6 because it's less work for the organization, right? Notice there you got applications, data, middleware, and the operating system that are typically managed in that model. The virtualization, server storage, network, firewalls, boundary protection, all of that is provided typically by the cloud provider. The next is really platform as a service. Notice the number there is 4, right? Less cost. Now, you have to, of course, factor in the cost of the cloud and make a balance, but I can tell you, again, after doing this for multiple decades, cloud technologies have streamlined this to a point where there is absolute cost savings. So here, applications and data, those are the 2 things that you really worry about in a platform as a service, not a heavy lift. Really, it's a service, but we're still changing things within that environment. And then the last model, number 2, over on the far right, software as a service. So software as a service is the least cost from an infrastructure and cyber perspective. Again, you have hosting costs. A great example of a software as a service would be Microsoft 365 or Office 365. No longer do I have to, as I did 20 years ago, manage large Exchange and Active Directory farms and file storage and all of that stuff. I don't have to manage that anymore. When I go to an Office 365 environment, it's all done for me. And that is truly a great example of software as a service. So we see here that the applications, data, networks, servers, all of that stuff, right? It must be secured. And that security has a direct cost as well. And so when we look at the security of the environment, we're really looking at controls. Now, controls are rules, things that we have to comply to. So we see an example there on the left, the protection of personal information, for example, PII or PHI, which is personal health information, has fewer controls than protection of an IT infrastructure and applications like your HR or finance system. The number of controls impacts cost because every control, a control example would be access. How are you managing access? Well, I'm doing it through my Active Directory server and I'm doing it through my LDAP server. Great. A cost is associated with that. Now, it may also be, how are you protecting your boundary, right? Your firewalls, how are you doing that work? What tools have you implemented? All of that. So it's not just the writing of the control itself. It's the actual work to implement that control that drives cost. So it's logical. More controls, more cost. Simple as that. Now, in a hosted model, like we see here, where our applications are local, yes, but we may have some controls that are inherited from our cloud providers, wonderful, but it's still not everything. You still have to build. So the more you use the services, as written there to the right, remember application data, middleware, and you see it inside of the clouds, the more cost you will have to secure the environment. Now, we haven't talked about other factors as well that will add to your cost related to the type of service that you select. So for example, on-site infrastructure as a service, you may still have to do penetration testing. You may have to do that for all of them, but you may have to do different levels of that for different services that you select. That has a cost. Remediation of events discovered has a huge cost. The management of those event logs, another cost, and the personnel needed, dependent upon the level of security you go, right? So within the federal government, for example, PII may be at the lower part, right? Non-protected is certainly the lowest, but protecting PII, but it just elevates from there all the way up to secure data or classified data. So dependent upon the level of security your organization requires, that cost increases as it relates to help desk support. So for example, if I'm running a non-classified PII data environment, I don't have to have 24/7/365 security operations center waiting to react to any event that's occurring. But if I have a secret or classified environment with data, I have to have the manpower, right, the labor hours put in bodies to watch those screens and make sure that bad things aren't happening in my environment. So again, lots of costs that impact our decisions as to where we place our data. It's not just about the cost of hosting versus the cost of my servers and storage. It extends far beyond that. And cyber and the security of our information is absolutely a critical component in that costing model.